Hello and welcome back to the History of Anime. In the last episode, we looked at the very beginning of Japanese animation. In this episode, we're going back to look at the decade where anime really started to form its industry. During this decade, anime started to air on TV and Japan got more recognition in the animation world. We see franchises begin that are considered some of the most important for the development of anime. Starting the decade off in 1961, Otoge Manga Calendar was aired on TV, making it Japan's first anime TV series. It aired for 4 years and documented various events in history with the use of animation. This was a little sneak peek in what the decade had in store. So last episode we saw the founding of Toei Animation. At Toei Animation worked a man by the name of Osamu Tezuka. But in 1961 he left Toei Animation, created Mushi Productions and started working on a number of anime that would come to be some of the most influential and important of his generation. The first would be the well-known Astro Boy series in 1963. Astro Boy really set the standard for shows in the 60s, and many studios were up for the challenge. Astro Boy followed the story of a powerful robot boy. Although the story might not have been as complex as shows to come, you can see Astro Boy's influence echoing through our anime series for decades to come. During the 60s, there were 4 or 5 main studios creating anime TV shows. Not only were there many new series created in this decade, but many new genres as well. Because there wasn't many solid anime shows or films created prior to the 60s, shows of this time had the opportunity to create their own genres. For example, Tetsujin 28 Go, also in 1963, was one of the early mecha series that would help start the mecha boom in the 70s and 80s. Much like Astro Boy, you can see how this show influenced future anime. It also successfully released in America a year later under the name of Gigantor. A few years later, in 1965, we see the release of Kimba the White Lion. This would be Japan's first coloured anime TV show. It would also be one of the more worldwide popular series at the time. People found it easy to watch as it was very similar to Disney's style. It was aired in loads of countries from Spain to Iran. A year later, in 1966, a show aired by the name of Sally the Witch. This was the first anime of the magical girl genre that would, like the mecha genre, blow up in the coming decades. It's also considered the first shoujo anime. Cyborg 009 would also start airing this year, a show that again would be very popular worldwide, and continue its success for decades. As the decade came to a close in 1968, Tezuka stood down from Mushi Productions to work on various projects of his own. The company went bankrupt in 1973, but was restored later in 1977. The decade closed with various shows like Tiger Mask and Dororo. The 60s ended up being so revolutionary compared to the prior decades. It marked the start of anime TV series and the start of multiple massive genres. We saw the founding of many important studios that developed various individuals like Tezuka. Really one of the most important decades for anime. So join me next episode where we take a look at the 1970s, a decade where anime took another massive step forward with huge quality boosts in the start of more genres and subgenres. But thank you very much for watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button and share it around.